Welcome back. The tragedy in Parkland, Florida is fueling debate on a number of bills in Olympia, while lawmakers continue to discuss a number of bills related to firearm restrictions and licensing requirements. There are also bills with specific school-centered proposals. The other side of the state, Senator Mike Padden of the Spokane Valley, is pushing legislation to require law enforcement agencies to notify public and private schools whenever there's a threat that might call for a lockdown or evacuation. His bill would also establish two regional safety centers to coordinate school safety policies related to threatening behavior and suicide prevention.
The idea behind the bill was try to enhance safety for our students, both those that attend public schools and those that attend private schools. And so there's two parts to the bill. The first part would be that the notification given to public schools if there's an incident where there's an active shooter or for some reason there has to be a lockdown due to a threat at a public school, that if there is a private school within 1 mile of that, the private school also would be notified, hopefully at the same time, so they also could take protective measures for the students in that school. And the other part of the bill calls for these regional safety centers that'd be run by the educational service districts, one west of the mountains and one east of the mountains. And they would provide a resource for analyzing behavioral health threats, information on suicide prevention, and in general safety information for schools. I think we've always had the notification. I think we had kind of a gap in our state that the private schools were not getting the notification. There were incidents where private schools found out only by seeing the, you know, police car or the fire engine go by headed to the other school, and then they took corrective action. So there's a gap there. But certainly, I think the behavioral health threat and being able to analyze that and use some of our knowledge of mental health problems, that area really hasn't been worked upon as much by our state. So I think that part would be a first. The whole idea is to try to protect these students.
As lawmakers in Olympia continue debating bills to restrict or tighten regulations on guns in Washington, there's also a debate about posting armed guards at schools. School security varies greatly across the country. Some districts have secure entry policies and limited access. Many also have metal detectors or requirements for clear backpacks. While both senators agree school safety and student well-being should be priorities, they have different perspectives on the approach the legislature should take. Senator McCoy isn't convinced dramatic physical security policies are realistic or warranted.
Do you have the money to do all that? Or do you just request the owners of weapons to lock them up? Put them away where they can't be easily accessed. And then the kids, pay attention to them. If you see them in stress, try to work out what their issues are. Work and walk them through it. So, you know, there's, again, you know, those are, I personally am not in favor of arming somebody and putting them in every school. I can't think through that one. It just bothers me. But I do worry about, you know, identifying the stressors that are on the kids and then doing something about those stressors.
Senator Padden says a one-size-fits-all approach to school security may not be the answer, but he believes armed security might be a good option for some schools.
A lot of the schools have resource officers. There's been some talk about getting retired military folks or retired law enforcement folks that also could maybe volunteer or work in some of the schools. We don't want to make the schools an armed camp, but we really do want to protect our students there. I think it could be. I mean, you're not going to have a completely armed school, with a whole bunch of people, but I think that could help. Another idea that I thought was very good is to, apparently there's an app out there that could be used for students to anonymously report any threats that they may be aware of. Like this case in Florida, where it seemed all the students knew, all sorts of people knew that this person was very dangerous, and the FBI had a tip that they didn't investigate on. But what if there had been an app and students could have actually sent information to the principal or somebody in authority to actually make sure something was done? So that's also an idea that has been considered. Well, it's very critical for adults, I mean, to safely secure their weapons. And I think education on these areas are very important, because there's a lot of folks in our country that, you know, believe strongly in the Second Amendment, that own guns. You're not gonna, you know, be able to take all the guns away from all the people. I don't think we want to do that. What I think we really need is to, for both sides to look at, well, what would really work? And like you say, it can be a very emotional deal. You can have an emotional response right at the beginning, but is that going to work? Is that going to solve the problem? And I think that's what we have to focus on. And again, whatever we can do to protect these students is the critical element. And we all do agree on trying to do that. And some of us have different ideas on what's best to do it. But I think we ought to go with evidence-based things that work.